morning, guys. Today I have something very different and unique for you. My name is James, and I'm going to show you a technique that I learned with my time here in Spain. We're going to be making reverse spherification. This is a technique, it's more of a gastronomic technique, but it's something that's very, very cool because you can use just about any liquid that you want to make little spheres. And you can go with salads, go with other things, and I'll show you a little more of that in other videos. But today, I just want to explain the basics of this process because it can be a little tricky if you don't really know what you're doing. But the technique was invented about 20 or so odd years ago by Ferran Adrià, who was the chef of El Bulli, if any of you know that, what that restaurant used to be. It used to be the most famous in the world, basically. It was a Michelin star restaurant. They invented this technique because the other technique is spherification, which is a little different, and I'll explain that in a bit. So before I explain the material and the process of making it, be sure to like the video down below, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done already, guys, and I'll explain now how we make spherifications. So for the materials that we're gonna need, it's important that we have these beforehand, because if you don't have this, you're not really gonna be able to make the spheres. And it just helps to have all the equipment and all the chemicals as well. So you're gonna need basically this little spherification spoon. You don't have to have it, but it helps when you extract the spheres. We're also gonna need a little squeeze bottle, which I'll show you how we're going to make this. We're gonna need a few measuring spoons as well as the chemicals and a puree, of course, of some sort. Now, first we're going to be making the water bath. We're gonna be using sodium alginate, which is the reverse spherification, because if we were doing the normal one, we'd be making a calcium bath with like calcium lactate, which we don't need. So it's reverse, we're doing the opposite. We're going to measure out first the amount of water that we want to use or how much liquid we're going to make. Then we're going to weigh and measure out the amount of sodium alginate that we're going to use. You want about 1% of powder to the amount of liquid. So it's a 1-to-100 ratio. Easy, no? We're going to then take some sort of blender. You can either use a actual blender or a hand blender if it's not that much. And you're going to add it to the water. You're going to blend it well. It needs to be blended very well. And then we're going to take this mixture, let it sit in the fridge for about an hour to even up to the day before to allow the bubbles to dissipate. This is important. We don't want any bubbles in this mixture. So normally I would make it ahead of time, and it's very easy to do. You just blitz it, put it in the fridge, forget about it, and then we'll work on the puree, and then we can make the spheres. Now the spheres that we're gonna make today are goat cheese spherifications. And to do that, we're just gonna take a little bit of goat cheese, put it in the pot. We're gonna add a little bit of cream, just a bit. And we just want to heat this up until it melts. We don't want to split the cheese, we don't want to do any of that. So just until it mixes together, more or less this thick, just until it's liquefied. If it's a little too thick, add a little bit of milk to it, but not too much. So we're just going to let this cool down until we put it in the bottle. Okay, now for the spherifications, for the fun part. We want to set up our little station and be extremely organized because, you know, it just helps with everything. And I've made thousands of these, so, you know, a setup like this will help. First, we want our little alginate bath in one bowl. We want a little bit of water in another. And if you're going to be storing these, the water's to wash them and the oil is to store them. You're going to leave them in either oil or another substance if you want to infuse, you know, more flavor into them. You're going to leave them in this, and they can last for several days depending on the liquid. Now we're going to do a tester. We want to take our measuring spoons, and depending on the size, I'm going to just use, say, half a teaspoon to test the liquid, but you can make the big ones as well. So you have all different sizes. This is the benefit of using the spoons. First, what you want to do is, there's a technique to this. You want to take the spoon, you want to put it in the water and the alginate bath first. Leave just a little bit in the spoon so it starts the process immediately. And then take your liquid of whatever you're doing and just fill it up. Fill it up, fill it up, fill it up. And then gently drop it in the water bath. Shake it if you have to, and that's it. It does take a little bit of time to get used to making these. It's been like a year since I've really made these. And it's like riding a bike. Once you make them again, you will remember. Now, one trick and one important thing. When you make these, you need to make sure that they're more or less perfectly round, because if they're not, if you have like this one, I didn't make really well. It has a little bit of a tail on it. And if that tail breaks, say on here or on the plate, it's gonna run out immediately. So if you have one of these, it's not a good one. You should either throw it out if you don't care about it, or be extra careful because those tails will break on any of these spoons. If you have any little residue on the spoon, what'll happen is this as well. You won't make a perfect one. So when you see a little bit of residue, wipe it off and start again. After about 30 seconds to a minute, or after you've made a few, you have to be careful with these, because if you make too many, then they start sticking together in the bath. Leave them for a little longer. But you can take them out. And this is why this spoon helps a lot, yes. You want to take a little bit of paper towel, just wipe off the excess gel, and then place them in the water. Clean it a little bit, wash them around, take it out of the water. Again, clean it, clean the excess gel off, and then you can put it in the oil. So another tip, if you have a little bit of liquid in the spoon, but then you use the tip of the nozzle here and it touches the bottom, it's not going to create a seal. So you're gonna end up with what I said earlier, like a tail. Whereas if you do it right, it'll be perfectly round like this one here. So just a few little tips. It takes a little bit of practice to make this. After a couple hundred or a couple dozen, you'll be fine. And after 1,000 or more, you'll be an expert.
So hopefully this has made a little bit of sense to you, so you can be able to make them yourselves at home. I hope I explained very well. It is a bit of a process, and if you are having problems, then just ask me and I'll be able to help you, and or also Google it online. There are other videos and there's a lot more information online as well. But the thing is, if you notice that they're starting to break on you a lot, and if you get that tail that I was talking about, be very, very careful. And if they are breaking on you a lot without that little tail, then just leave them in the alginate bath a little longer to form a, more of a thicker skin to them. And that should be it. They go great with pastries, main courses, as well as salads, and you know, they're pretty flexible. You can use, like I said, with any material. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope it was informational for you as well. Be sure to like the video down below, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more content, and you'll be seeing more of these spherifications in later videos as well, since I have all the material. So thank you for watching, guys. I'll catch you again very soon.